Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for November 4th of 2021, well, it is titled NGC 147 and NGC 185. So what do we see here? Well, here is an image of two galaxies, and these are two small satellite galaxies, not of our Milky Way, but of the Andromeda Galaxy. So looking out about 2.5 million light years away toward the Andromeda system, and you can't see the larger Andromeda Galaxy in this system. This is actually a pair of two relatively close galaxies, only about 35,000 light years across. Apart. So that's roughly how far these are away from each other. And much as we have binary stars where we have two stars orbiting each other, this is a binary galaxy system. So we see galaxies grouped together much as stars do. But in this case, we're actually seeing two galaxies that are orbiting around each other, while the rest of the they also orbit the Andromeda Galaxy. So we can see that galaxies do group together, which we know, but they even group together in much smaller groups than we generally think about. We tend to think of galaxies in big clusters, but we also can see that galaxies do combine together in other forms as well, as we see here. Now, these are classified as what is known as dwarf spheroidal galaxies, so spherical galaxies, very small, not like the giant elliptical galaxies. These have no gas or dust and no signs of star formation. So we don't see, they have resemble elliptical galaxies in that matter, in that they are not forming any types of stars. They're also extremely faint, meaning that we don't see them over large distances. So they don't have a very large luminosity, and can be very difficult to see. And that's why we see them generally within our own local group area. So as things that orbit around Milky Way or Andromeda, but they would be hard to see over very great distances. When we look over great distances, we see the largest and brightest galaxies that can be seen over many millions or even billions of light years. These galaxies would be invisible, although they likely form a large number of galaxies. We simply cannot see them. And we have the same concern with stars. When we look at stars out in the night sky, we tend to see the biggest and brightest types of stars, very rare and unusual ones. Whereas the most common types of stars are completely invisible to the naked eye, even if they happen to be very close to us. So that was our picture of the day for November 4th of 2021. It was titled NGC 147 and NGC 185. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture. So until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.